transistors, diodes, integrated circuits, photosensors, memory units, graphic processing units used in computers, and many other electronic devices are made up of semiconductors. Semiconductors are crystalline or amorphous solids that can conduct electricity under specific circumstances, making it a good medium to control electrical current in various applications. But how did these small electronic components made from sand come to dominate the entire field of science and technology since the mid-20th century? The main reason is that they are imperfect. Imperfect in the sense of electrical conductivity. So what decides conductivity? According to the Bohr atomic model, electrons in an isolated atom have discrete energies depending upon their orbits. These orbits come in different layers around the nucleus, with the orbits closest to the nucleus having the lowest energy level and increasing as we move further away. When atoms come together to form solids, electrons in the outer orbit overlap with nearby atoms to form energy bands with continuous energy variation. The energy band, which includes the outer shell electrons or valence electrons, is called the valence band. The energy band above the valence band is called the conduction band. In insulators, the electrons in the valence band are separated by a large energy gap from the conduction band. In conductors like metals, the valence band overlaps with the conduction band. Semiconductors have energy gaps lower than insulators and greater than conductors. In absolute zero temperature, semiconductors act like insulators. With little energy, electrons can move from valence band to conduction band, thus bringing conduction property. They can be pure elements like silicon, germanium, or compounds like gallium arsenide. It is not easy to change the conductivity of conductors and insulators. However, we can change the conductivity of semiconductor material by doping. We will see about what doping is in detail shortly. Holes in electrons are two types of charge carriers responsible for the flow of current in semiconductors. When temperature increases, more energy becomes available to these electrons. So they break away from their valence band to conduction band and create a hole in their original site. A hole is the absence of an electron in a particular place in an atom. Although it is not a physical particle as an electron, it can be passed down from one atom to another in a semiconductor material. Let's discuss the two important semiconducting materials, silicon and germanium. Silicon has got a total of 14 electrons, out of which 4 electrons are in the outermost orbit. Similarly, germanium has got a total of 32 electrons, with 4 electrons in its outermost orbit. In crystalline structure, each atom shares its outer orbit electrons with the nearby atoms. This is called covalent bond. Only these electrons in the outermost shells are responsible for conductivity. So let's concentrate them alone. Silicon and germanium in their pure state are called intrinsic semiconductors. At absolute zero temperature, outer shell electrons shuttle back and forth the neighboring atoms and hold them strongly. When temperature increases, electrons break away from their valence band to conduction band and create a hole in their original site. The free electron moves completely independently as a conduction electron and gives rise to an electron current, i.e., under an applied electric field. Under the action of an electric field, these holes move towards negative potential, giving the hole current, IH. Do not confuse this apparent movement of holes with the real movement of electrons. The total current I is thus the sum of electron current and the hole current. Conductivity of intrinsic semiconductors depends on its temperature and they have limited scope of application. In order to have better control over conductivity, materials called impurities are added to the semiconducting elements. This process is called doping. Number of charge carriers can be increased by adding impurities to the semiconducting elements. Semiconductors made through the doping process are called extrinsic semiconductors. Arsenic, antimony, phosphorus are the commonly used impurities having valency of 5 and called pentavalent impurities. Indium, boron, aluminium are the commonly used impurities having valency of 3 and are called the trivalent impurities. When a pentavalent atom is added to the silicon, 4 of its electrons form a covalent bond with the 4 silicon neighbors, while the 5th electron remains weakly bound to the parent atom. As less energy is required to set this 5th electron free, they start moving freely in the lattice of semiconductor at room temperature. Total number of electrons is the sum of electrons contributed by pentavalent donors and those generated intrinsically. But holes are generated only due to intrinsic sources. By changing the level of doping, we can change the number of conduction electrons. Hence, in an extrinsic semiconductor doped with pentavalent impurity, electrons become the majority carriers and holes become the minority carriers. These are called n-type semiconductors. Similarly, when a trivalent impurity is added to the silicon, it forms covalent bonds with the three nearby silicon atoms and does not have an electron to offer to the fourth silicon atom. So the bond between the trivalent impurity and the fourth silicon atom creates a hole. An electron from the nearby silicon atom may jump to fill this hole, thus creating a vacancy in the new site. Thus, the hole is available for conduction. These are in addition to the intrinsically created holes. Finally, due to large numbers, positively charged holes become majority carriers and electrons become minority carriers. Therefore, extrinsic semiconductors doped with trivalent impurity are called p-type semiconductors. Now let's see how a simple semiconducting device diode is formed. When p-type semiconductor is fused to n-type semiconductor, they form a p-n junction in which electrons and holes from two sides form an equilibrium zone called depletion region. This region is free of charge carriers. These p-n junction diodes can be used as solar cells, rectifiers, and in LED lighting applications. Let us discuss the formation and functioning of diodes and transistors in another video. Thank you for watching this video. For more such science and engineering videos, subscribe to Black Story.